Welcome to a brief introduction of the field of linguistics. My name is Dr. Shelby Miller, and today we're going to quickly review what linguistics is and what types of things we might study in linguistics. You're probably all familiar with hashtags, which are used on social media to index keywords or phrases. Social media users can use these hashtagged words or phrases to easily explore other posts or pages that discuss the same topics. Like its use on social media, I call this my hashtag linguistics presentation because I'm encouraging you to explore the field of linguistics and the many branches of study that fall under linguistics. So, what is linguistics? To put it simple, linguistics is the study of language, any and every language. When we study language, there are a ton of facets to explore. So in linguistics, we have subfields or core areas that study different aspects of language. Listed in front of you are only part of the areas that one might study in linguistics, but those listed here are the ones we're going to explore in our time together. Today, we're going to quickly explore each one of these on our list so you can start thinking as a linguist thinks. However, many of these areas, if not all of them, are probably new to you. In fact, when I say a word like orthography, it probably goes in one ear and out the other, meaning it's unfamiliar and sounds complicated. But don't worry. If you speak a language, as I know all of you do, you're actually already equipped with a lot of linguistic knowledge. And in this video and others, you're partially going to be able to rely on what you already know about language to help you understand what you need to know about the principles of language study. This is because you're not a blank slate. You may not know how to build a house, but you do know that it takes nails and wood. You may not know how a car engine works, but you do know how to put gas in a car to keep it going. And you may not know much or anything about linguistics, but you do know that something is wrong with a sentence like, "the grass green it was." Your implicit knowledge of language is going to assist you in the study of linguistics. So let's quickly dive into our core areas and start building on your linguistic knowledge by seeing a few examples of language through a linguistics viewpoint. This introduction is by no means going to cover everything, and other videos will go far more in depth on each topic. But for now, let's get our feet wet by glancing at each core area, starting with phonology. Phonology is the study of sounds. In fact, when you study phonology, you can basically cover your eyes and let your ears do the learning. Because here we're learning about the sounds in a language. By studying phonology, we learn that words are made up of small units of sound called phonemes. We can take the word lead, for example, and see that it is made up of three sounds, l, e, d. We also learn about why words rhyme, such as lead and read, and the importance of things like rhyming and teaching. We'll learn that while perfect and perfect are spelt the same, they sound different for a reason. And we look at how sound changes the meaning between the sentences, I will lead him home and I will lead him home. On the surface, these look like the same sentences, but using sound or stress emphasizes different information. If it has to do with sound, it has to do with phonology. In orthography, we study spelling systems. More specifically, we look at how sound, phonology, relates to spelling, orthography. We learn why some words are spelt the same but pronounced different, such as lead and led or read and read. We also explore spelling rules and why some don't work, such as the rule to spell it how it sounds, which clearly doesn't apply to a word like baloney. We then examine how all these things impact the way people learn to read and learn new languages. In morphology, we study how words are made. So where do we get slang words like sus, salty, and OMG? How are new words created and added to the English language? And what process allows for the word establish to morph into the word anti-disestablishmentarianism? This is a really fun field that reminds you how fun the words in a language can be. In syntax, we study the structure of a sentence. Most of you likely know this field under another name known as grammar. Here we explore why Cookie Monster saying, me want cookie, disobeys English syntax. Why we use a comma in, before I go, let me eat, but not in, let me eat before I go. And why we can say, she likes coffee, but not, she coffee likes. As speakers of English, you likely already know that, she coffee likes doesn't work. It's not a standard English sentence. And in our time together, we'll uncover exactly why that's the case. In semantics, we study the meaning of words, phrases, sentences, and text. We look at why bark and bark are spelt the same and sound the same, but mean different things when we say, I bark at the tree bark. We look at how the English word family means the same thing as the Spanish word familia, but also how the English word exit does not mean the same thing as the Spanish word éxito. We also explore why phrases like break a leg can be really confusing to language learners, where on the one hand, it sounds awful to wish a broken leg on someone, but in English, it actually means to wish someone luck. In pragmatics, we study deeper meaning, or even hidden meaning. This is different than semantics in that the meaning of the speaker is beyond the word level and hidden in context. Let's take the following sentence as an example. If you eat all of that food, it will make you bigger. Semantically, bigger in this sentence would mean larger than you are currently. But think about how this sentence would mean something different depending on the context. For example, if you said it to a young child, pragmatically, it would mean to grow bigger, which is something we want our children to do. However, if you said the same sentence to a grown person who is worried about their weight, it would mean something entirely different and most likely be considered very rude. In sociolinguistics, we look at how all of our language is encoded with societal influence. So how region, the city, the state, the country you grew up in all influence the style of English you speak right now. So does your ethnicity, gender, and age, amongst many other variables. Sociolinguistics is the study of sociology alongside language. As we move through all of those linguistic subfields, we're going to tie everything back to how these things impact those learning their L1, their first language, and those learning their L2, their second language. We will simultaneously explore how each of these fields is brought into language teaching with a focus on TESOL, the teaching of English to speakers of other languages. So there you have it. You now have had a basic introduction to many large core areas in the discipline of linguistics. In our next videos, we're going to take our investigation further by exploring each of these areas a little more in depth, starting first with sociolinguistics. You're going to have a fantastic time learning about linguistics. Wishing you the best along this journey. In other words, break a leg.